Today we got to move our electric eel from his original exhibit that he's been in since it opened into a new exhibit, a little bit larger with more structures and plants and wood and things for him to explore. Of course, the main concern was his electric shock, that if he decided to give a discharge, we needed to be prepared. So the big thing was just wearing rubber gloves, the ones that I used on a daily basis whenever I had to clean inside his exhibit. And we just used a two net system just to make sure he was comfortable in one net, and then we used another one just kind of as extra support. And we just very carefully handed him to a couple different people, kind of like an assembly line, and got him safely into the new exhibit.
Here he is.
He's definitely doing a lot of exploring. It's going to take a while, I'm sure, because there's so much more things and objects in this exhibit than his previous one. So it'll take him some time, I'm sure, since he can't really see very well and he's using that electricity to find his way around. It'll take him a while to sort of kind of map the exhibit, and so he kind of gets familiar with where things are. The first thing that people, of course, they will hear the noise and then they'll go, what's that? And then they look and they see the lights. Right away, they think that the animal itself is making that noise. Well, unfortunately, it's a little bit of wizardry on our part. We have three different electrical probes that are in the water picking up all the pulses that the electric eel is giving off. I think people just are astounded that an animal can produce electricity, and so for us to be able to have one on display really helps educate people and to show that we have an animal like this that lives, you know, normally in the wild they're found in little mud holes. So for him to be able to be displayed like this, people can see him, they can see from the lights and sound, they can hear him giving off his discharge.